Hello and welcome to another episode of Lemur's Corner. Today, guys, we're going to be going over Giga Tames, how to tame them really easy and everything. It's going to be really simple. We are in my non-dedicated world, however, we've only going to do this. Doesn't really make a difference. Basically, we just spawn the stuff in instead of building it, but it works just fine on any server. It doesn't matter. It's pretty much the way just to do it without having to worry about getting killed by the Giga or running away or anything like that. So basically, guys, we're looking for Gigas right now. They can spawn up here in the snow. We're on the island specifically on this map, and they could spawn here on the snow on both the smaller and the bigger mountain. I normally check the smaller one first, and then there's Giga Mountain, which we'll take you guys over to either here in a minute or actually at the end of the video, I'll show you where they spawn over on Giga Mountain. So we're going to go ahead and fly around, guys, try to find one for you guys to see and tame, and everything should go well. We've got some long necks, some darts, Quetzal Kibble, and narcotics. Make sure you have lots of narcotics because they lose to poor very quickly, so you have to pump them pretty consistently and keep them asleep, and they take a long time otherwise. That was a Rex down there. I was going to be excited for a minute there. So we're going to go ahead. We'll fast forward. We'll just go ahead and jump ahead to where we find the Giga, or we go over to the other mountain and show you guys. We do have Alpha Eagle with us. He's going to be helping us out because this is kind of a two-man thing. You can one-man tame it this way. It works just fine. It's just a little bit easier two people, so I've got Alpha Eagle helping me out today. So we'll see you guys here in a minute. Alright guys, we're here over at the Giga Mountain, as I like to call it. Basically, as you can see right here on the map, you see where the pin is. It's right over here at about 30, 40 on the latitude side and 70 to 80 on the longitude side. We're looking for a Giga right now. I hear Eagle pulling stuff out, so we really can't tell what's going on. They can be all over the mountain. They can be on the forest around the mountain. They can be wherever, and we'll find it here, hopefully. But that's the major two spawn points. They can get kited around sometimes. On the center, they spawn on the jungle islands normally or on volcano up north. So those are the best spots to look for those. I'm not seeing anything, but that's where they spawn over there. So those are the two major spawn points for the center, and this is the two major spawn points for the island. And we'll go ahead and see if we can find one, guys. So we'll go ahead and see you guys here in a minute once we find one. I don't want you guys to have to sit here and watch. Let's just float around looking for a Giga. All right, guys, we found one. Yay! You can see it over here fighting those RGs. It's going to eat them pretty well as it just munches them apart. Nom, 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 nom. So, guys, basically now we found it. We know we need to kite it down. I think we're going to do it on the beach. I think it's going to be the best spot to do this. You guys need behemoth gates. I always make about 6 to 8 just so you have extra ones. So we're going to make a little trappy trap. Here's the biggest thing, though, guys. You need to try to find a spot where you can stand above the behemoth gates and shoot down. So what we're going to do, I think right over here, Eagle, do you think this is a good spot over here? I think it is. Right against this cliff, we can just pull it down and tame it right here. I think there might be a Rex over here, but I'm not too worried. So I'm going to go ahead and put Eagle down. He's got all the behemoth gates on him. He's going to get these things set up and clear them up, and he's going to clear the land, and then I'll grab the behemoth gates and put them down. So we're going to clear the land for you guys real quick, and we'll be back here in a second once we get the land clear. All right, guys, we're back. We did some clearing real quick. No big worries. So what I'm going to do is I've got a bunch of behemoth gates. I have 8 on me right now, as I said. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make kind of a dino pen, I guess would be, with the gates. It doesn't need to be perfect here, guys, just so you guys know. You just kind of put them down so that they block them off. And pretty much what you want is the doors are going to tank the dino or the Giga inside of it. And then your buddy is going to technically close the behemoth gate behind you. And he shouldn't take any shots if he does it well. And let's go ahead and I'll actually show you guys how to do it solo probably. It'll probably work best. I'm doing this a little bit larger than I normally would have, just to show you guys. But all I'm doing is placing down these behemoth gates really nicely. Place them in here just like this. I do want to do a spot for us to shoot down. As you guys can see, I'm kind of creating a gap in here. The reason I'm doing that, as I said, is so that we have a place to shoot down from. And we don't have to worry about it. So now we're going to place all these doors on here. No worries. As I said, this is a little bit larger than I normally would have done it. However, it'll work out just fine. No major problems or anything. I'm not worried about it. Put these doors in, and voila. So then we'll be up top on that little ledge right there where the Giga can't get us, shooting down into here, into this pen we just created for this thing. So what we need to do first is we need to go ahead and kite it. Eagle is going to go ahead, and I hope he's okay. As you guys can see, we have a bunch of stuff ready, Quetzal Kibble and stuff. He's going to use his tech gear and float around. Eagle, want to go ahead and just stand down here and show him how to do the door So basically, because I have a little gap underneath it right here, if you guys see, basically what he can do is he can shut the door and sneak out at the same time. And actually, if you just go ahead, when you fly in here, what you can also do is once you've got him in here, you just fly back over with your bird and you just face check it and then go ahead and go back, which I can just do that way. So Eagle, I'm going to go ahead and kite him in if you want to get up top and get ready to start shooting. So we'll go ahead and get this done real quick. Let's go find this baby and get him to chase us. It's good to do a pterodon. I do have a little bit of speed in this, but you can have just a normal speed pterodon that works just fine. He's going to come pretty quickly, Eagle, just, you know, we'll get some stamina back. Eagle, what are you doing? I guess Eagle's going to kite them, I guess, is what he's going to do. But basically all you guys do is you guys get his attention, get him to chase you, I'm hoping. See if we can find him. Oh, there he is. Found him. So maybe he'll come get us. Got an open gate. Oh, yeah, he popped us once here, guys. So what I'm doing right here is I'm turning him around, actually, because you want to have a pretty good straight shot into the taming pen. And so we're going to see. We're going to turn him around. He should chase us. I'm hoping maybe if I land, we'll get him to chase us. You know you want to come get me. Here he comes. He doesn't hear him coming. Oh, he's stuck on some rocks. Of course. Mr. Special Giga. Come on. Come on, bud. Get me. So we'll go ahead and pull him out here a little bit. There we go. You guys can hear the stomping. I'll show you guys in the background. So what you do is you walk him in. You sit at the end. It's really good just to sit, turn. Wait for him to come. Come on. Right here. No. Come get me. Yeah. Add. Oh, almost bad things just occurred. So then you guys turn, as I said. You come over, face check the door, and close that baby real quick, and then bam. We're in good shape, so you guys can see he's doing damage to that door. Eagle's up top already. We're going to land quickly, jump off, and we're going to go ahead and start shooting this baby. So what we're going to do, though, guys, is you guys can tell I have damage on. If you don't have damage, you can tell it's the same thing. But basically what you want to do is you just want to keep shooting them. Gigas will not die from taking too much damage, so just shoot them as fast as you can, especially if they happen to get out for some reason. When they run away, then you don't have to worry about it. But basically what we're going to do, guys, is we're going to shoot this thing, pump it full. But once it goes to run away, so when it's running and not attacking anymore, we're going to slow down and try to pace it out. One person should shoot. Both of you should not shoot anymore, which I'm the designated shooter for this. So as soon as it starts to run away, I'll call it out to Eagle. He'll stop shooting, and I'll just do my timers on it and everything. And basically what you want to do, you don't have to do a timer, but basically what you want to do is you want to pay attention to if the thing's going to fall down. Because you don't want to hit it an extra time. And that's one thing about when you do double shooting, triple shooting and stuff. Sometimes what happens is someone shoots it and messes the whole taming efficiency up. So it's just a terrible thing to happen. So we're going to go ahead and shoot this guy for a little bit. I'm not going to make you guys sit here and watch it. And it will, those dino gates will hold. I have had a 150 in here chewing on those dino gates, on those behemoth gates, and it doesn't go down. So don't worry too much, guys. As I said, we'll see you guys here in a minute once this thing's down or it's getting ready to run away, and we'll talk about how I'm counting it out or how I'm paying attention. And we'll see you guys here in a minute. All right, guys, we're back. So basically you guys can see it is no longer attacking our building. It's running away. So I'm just going to shoot it, pay attention, see if it falls down, and we're just waiting for this thing to fall over. What you want to try to do is you want to try to aim to the highest point possible. So when this thing falls, if you happen to shoot after it falls for the support stack up or something, it just falls over and you don't have to worry about accidentally hitting it. You can space these out. You do have 5 seconds between them. I like to just kind of spam it a little bit. You can see him running around a little bit. He's not happy because he got whacked a little bit. I also did talk to Eagle while we were in the fast forward shooting the thing. I actually teleported him. That's why he actually ended up kiting him. Luckily, he had tech tier on and was able to get away, otherwise he would have been squishied. Because we're on a non-dedicated server, so I totally forgot about that. I should have grabbed Eagle. That was my fault. I'm so used to playing on a dedicated or official that I totally forgot. So hopefully this thing will go down here in a minute. I'm really hoping. And then as soon as it does, here's the biggest thing, guys. You guys need to try to get that narcotic in there right away. Because if you don't get that narcotic right in there right away, this thing can wake up. Its Tapor comes up super, super fast. So you need to try to pump it in there. And because if you guys watched my last video, if you looked at the taming basics, you know narcotic lasts for 16 seconds. So what you do is if every 16 seconds, or I do about 10 seconds, all you need to do is pop a new narcotic to keep it passed out. So about every 10 seconds, you just go ahead, pop a new narcotic. Don't even give it a chance to even start gaining tapor. It's really your best bet here, is what you want to do. This thing's being a little tougher than I thought. I want this thing to go down. Oh, there it goes. Do you guys see that? So that's what I'm talking about, right? Sometimes what happens is it just jumps down. I think Eagle's just going to jump down with his tech tier. He's already down there. So we've got our bird. Our bird's loaded up. And then what ends up happening, he's going to grab all that narcotic. He grabbed that kibble. I think he's already got it on him. And he's going to throw it in there. And then what he's going to do is I'll show you guys here in a second. I'm going to do it initially, and then I'm going to go into coverage mode to show you guys. But pretty much what you do is you sit there. You guys can see how fast that Tapor is going down. So I do one, and then they go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 1, 2, 3, and you just rinse and repeat over those 10 seconds. Technically, you could wait to 16, but in this situation, because it's a giga, I always try to do it on a higher number, a lower number, because I don't want it to wake up because its Tapor drops so dang fast. So what we're going to do is we're going to leave Eagle in charge of this, and as this is Kibble in here with Quetzal Kibble, so Quetzal Kibble is still 80 food, so when it gets to 80 food, you guys will see it jump up real quick and get a bunch of tame efficiency. Eagle's in there now doing the narcotics, not too worried about it. So the reason I like to do two people, especially on PvP servers, what you're better off doing is trying to kite it back to your base and taming it at your base. But if you're on a PvP server and it's still early on and people don't have a lot of stuff, you want to have people flying around and protecting your base. Eagle, I'm not pulling too far away from you. If I am, let me know. I'm trying to stay close to him because, as I said, we are on a non-dedicated. We don't have to worry about it. But I want you guys to see, like, you have to kind of fly out here, pay attention to your cliff, see what's around you. And if I'm on a PvP server and someone comes near this bird or this thing, I'm plucking them right away. I don't even care what you're saying. You're staying away from my Giga because this tame is going to be very important. So this is a level 50. It was a pretty good pretty good for the first one. You can get higher levels. Once you've gotten to this point, it really doesn't matter. It's just about how many darts you end up wasting and stuff like that. I also like using Behemoth Gates down here because you can sit on the Behemoth Gates and really pay attention to what's going on. You can go back up to your little sniping location back here and find out what's happening. It shouldn't be big of a deal. But what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and land back down here, get back in the inventory, and right before this thing stands up, we'll go ahead and start the video again. You guys can see it. We do have a saddle with us, so it'll be kind of exciting. So we'll see you guys all here in a minute. All right, guys, we're back. So we're about to get this Giga. It's about to stand back up. It's taken a couple kibble. We're still pumping narcotics into it, even though it's got a ton of it. It should eat in 5 food. So it should be at 39.60 is when it'll eat. It'll probably eat about 59.7 or something like that. It normally doesn't eat right away. But it should eat pretty quickly. And then we're going to go ahead. You guys see we got some raw meat in there for when it stands up. 59.9. I'm sorry, guys. I missed it. So we won't name this guy yet. We'll go ahead and grab some of this stuff out of here just so we have it. And we'll go ahead and re-enter the inventory on it because, as you guys can see, you can't equip the saddle if you've got it in there prior to actually taming it. So we can go ahead and jump up here. Oh, look at this thing. It's going to be so awesome. So I want to kind of give you guys a little talk about this while we walk, because the one thing is while it's nice to have a Giga tamed and everything, the biggest catch I'm going to tell you guys right now is there are a couple things that are do's and don'ts for Giga specifically, and it more relates to its health and stamina and stuff like that. So we're going to go ahead and discuss those here real quick also. So if you guys look on the right side of my screen, you'll see like a little, I'm going to try to send it out to the sun. You guys see that little like heart face? It's actually a face with lightning in it is what I believe it is in the hair. But basically once it fills, the Giga will enrage. And when a Giga enrages, it turns against everything and just murders people. And it's really a good idea to do when you're raiding someone. So normally it takes one rocket. Will cause a Giga to enrage. And I also wanted to put a couple levels on this thing because leveling it up is actually not what you would expect it to be. I'm going to obviously mess up the levels on this one when I do this. If anyone's tamed the Giga before and this knows exactly what I'm about to do, I'm going to show you guys what to level up in it and why to level it up and why you really don't want to level anything else up into it. So we're going to go ahead start cutting through here. We're all the way at Red Ob pretty much. Its stamina is terrible. So let's go ahead and take a look at these levels. So basically, guys, I'm going to go ahead and show you its health is at 17.4. If I were to increase its health, I get 0.7. Or I'm sorry, 7 health. So increasing its health does absolutely nothing for a Giga. So it's at 10% that it enrages if it takes 10% damage over a certain period of time. So then if I click stamina, it gives it 4 stamina. Oh my goodness, why are we even leveling this thing up on that stuff? I mean, that's why I said, you know, there's specific things you level up in these things. I'm trying to kill some stuff here real quick and give it some levels. We're going to start making our way back here in a minute. Let's jump through these trees real quick, get our way in here. Eagle's following us up top with the bird. Oh, there's a something in there. Dimorphodon, Dilophosaurus. We got ourselves another level. But basically, you guys can see you don't develop up oxygen because you're not going to be swimming with it. Food is not a thing you really need to have on there. Weight is the same problem you're going to have with the other ones, but I'll go ahead and click it for you guys. You got a whole 30 weight. Oh boy. Gigas really don't do much other than you pump food into them, but they're going to be chewing stuff up. But really, what you're going to want to put the points into, because even speed, these things are pretty quick to begin with. And actually, if I'm walking this back, and the reason I'm doing that right now is just to gain some levels on it. And I'm trying to hope to get the level here in a second, but it doesn't look like I'm going to get one. But basically what I want to do is I want to get one more level, because what you want to level up, guys, is melee damage. Melee damage is the only thing that's worth any level on these things. And that's the key here. Let's go ahead and turn towards these parasaurs I just saw. Let's go to first person if you guys want to see it. We can see it's chomping up some stuff here. Just chip up this Magnera. There we go. We got a level really easily. So I'm going to go ahead and level up the melee damage just to show you guys what you get from that specifically. So melee damage is the only thing I want to go up. If you guys look, it's 75%. You hit the A button, you get 0.6. And really, that's about it. If you're going to put nothing in, I'd rather put nothing into melee damage personally. That's my opinion. You can do whatever you want technically, but in my opinion, if you're going to do something, if health's not going to get much health, if you're not going to get much of anything else from it, I think you're better off just putting it into melee damage and increasing your melee damage. As you guys saw, I did extra damage there. Not a ton. But if you put 60 levels in there at 0.6, it's still going to get you 30% higher. So in my book, that's 30% higher, which puts your melee damage over 100%. So you're going to get an extra 25% damage, which is better than, what would that be, 30 or like 300 health. I do want to push this off a cliff, kind of intentionally. It's not going to end well for me probably, but I want to do this. Reason I want to do this, guys, is so you guys can see that rage bar fill. That's too big of a cliff. Let's just go ahead and sneak through here. Maybe we can get some stuff to attack us or something. So basically, guys, I'm just going to go ahead and try to get this rage bar to fill up real quick. If it kills us, it kills us. No big deal. We're just going to walk through this swamp real quick and get through here. I just need to get up on a hill. And we should be good to go for that. As I said, we're in first person, so I'm going to jump back out to third person because I find it easier. Here we go. I can kind of climb up this hill a little bit and jump off the side. Of course, he doesn't take fall damage when I did it. Let's go. Come on. There we go. He's still not raging. Come on. This thing's being so slow. Sorry for the giant trees in the way, guys. I do want to get this back to my base eventually. And really what you want to do if you're taking it back is just go ahead and take it with following a bird. Because here, we'll just go ahead and chew this guy real quick. And he should attack us and do some damage. And show you guys what's happening. So you guys can see I'm taking 2 damage at a time from this thing. And it's really not doing diddly booby to the rage bar. So I need to find a cliff to jump off of. And I think we've got one right here, Eagle. This looks like a good cliff. Yes, it does. I hope I don't rage this thing and get myself killed, but so be it if we do. Here we go. We're going to go ahead and jump off. You guys can look at that rage bar next to the health plus. And there it is. So I did successfully enrage it. We're going to run away as fast as possible. God, Eagle, save me. Oh, it hurts. I do have infinite stats on. I'm not going to lie to you guys. So it's going to break probably all my armor. It's not happy. How you guys can tell it's enraged is if you guys look at its eyes, they're bright yellow. It's the only reason I kind of wanted to do this because I knew I was going to try to enrage it. And then as it dies out, it goes red, and then it becomes your friend again. I took it from too high up. So I did myself not so well on that one, but you guys can see the health damage it took and everything, and it enraged on you. So that pretty much sums up the tutorial right there. I think that was a good thing to see you guys know. So don't jump it off cliffs. As I said, what you do is I'm going to go ahead and jump off this bird. Eagle will scoop me off of this thing. Hopefully I'll jump on its head so he can grab me, and then he'll tell it to follow him, and it's so much easier to do it that way than the other. I don't know what this thing's doing to me. Are you stuck in it, Eagle? You're stuck in it. So just have your bird follow it, and you guys can take it back. It's much easier. It doesn't waste any stamina or anything. It works much better. So I'll just go ahead and jump off the side here for Eagle so he can grab me, and he'll go ahead and fly us back real quick if he can scoop me. Eagle, you're looking terrible on camera, bruh. I will whistle passive, but you guys can see if he flies a little bit higher, it's actually pretty quick. He needs to get caught in its mouth, I guess, is what he really wanted to do. So we'll see you guys on the next episode. We'll go ahead and call it quits right there. We've done a lot of talking and everything. Make sure you guys fly high enough to where you don't have this exact thing happen. Eagle, you're going to have to drop me so you can get this thing and I'll move it for you. So he's going to drop me and I should be able to ride it and move this thing for him so he can get out of there. There he goes. So I'll go ahead and jump down. And we'll see you guys on the next episode. Don't worry about it. And make sure you guys subscribe or like to the channel if you enjoy what you're seeing. Eagle, you forgot about me. And we'll see you guys on the next episode here.